All right, we're back. Yeehaw. We have the finals getting ready to kick off for the women's division of the 2016 Southwest Regionals in Scottsdale, Arizona. Bernie Storr is the hot seat, and Pearl has come through the loser side. So Pearl's got to beat Bernie twice. Bernie has a Fargo rating of 582, so she has to go to 5, and Pearl has a 452 rating, and she has to go to 3. Bernie's going to have her hands full with this girl. Pearl is playing lights out right now. Both of them have been breaking pretty good all tournament long. Choices, choices here. A few of them broke out, but she didn't land very good on any of them. I think she's got the 7 here. She can cut, maybe. Ooh, maybe not. That'd be pretty tough. Well, she gave it a shot. She needed to hit a little thinner. That was pretty tough. Well, and Bernie's already having a good event. Her and her partner, Adam Pyon, just won the Scotch Doubles this morning. And she's in the finals of the women's singles. Alright, thanks, Rick. So Veronica did beat Pearl earlier in the tournament, and now Pearl just beat Veronica to get into the finals. Alright, now try it, Bill.
I'm back with you. I had to visit the boys' room. So we got the final, Pearl has to beat Bernie twice.
Yeah, they jumped on it pretty quick. Bernie's got the solids.
And Bernie's going to 5, and Pearl's going to 3. And I just heard that Veronica actually was the person that put Pearl on loser's side.
Yeah, and then Pearl got her revenge.
Yes, she did.
Pearl is playing really strong right now. Bernie will have her hands full.
Yep.
Well, she's clearing out the top of the table.
Yeah, she's then come down here and she's got to deal with that 12 ball. It only goes in one pocket right now, it looks like.
If it goes there.
Goes up in the corner, does it? Maybe. Maybe it doesn't.
Yeah, kind of hard to tell.
It might go on the side.
Again, we're real sorry we don't have the aerial view. The blimp went down this morning.
Well, that was an interesting position. Looks like she's got to go. Well, she can play the 12 right now on the side, I think.
Yeah, if she's going to shoot in the side, you may be.
I may be coming down and taking a peek.
Well, Brett showed up. Yeah. Hey, hey, hey.
We'll call him over and make him do something.
Brett is the director of training for the BCAPL referees, or I should say the CSI referees. And he's also dressed very casual today. He looks like he's about to go
to the beach, maybe?
Yeah.
He's got a flip-flop. No, he's got his sandals on.
He got sandals on, and is that camouflage shorts? So he's got his Duck Dynasty shorts on, and his sandals. I think he forgot we're loading out today. But I will stick him in the booth. If this match double dips, I'll give him the second half, and I'll go out and start moving pool tables. We got the truck ready, and the Bad Boys team is ready to head home.
Dude, looks like the semifinal match and the mixed team started.
Well, hopefully this will all time out right so that when this match is done, we can get the men's finals team event on here. We got to make sure if they get done before this that we hold them up a bit so we do stream it. Look at that. Gosh, she's shooting so good right now.
Good shot. And she landed real good on the 15.
I'm telling you.
She can just stop her cue ball and shoot the 11.
She may have had a little powwow with the pool gods before this event because everything's going right for her right now.
Apparently they listened.
I could say something about a sacrifice and something, but somebody would just go nuts over that. So we'll just say she had a little powwow with the pool gods. And it's all clicking. Her stroke is good. Her ball speed has been great. The shape has been really nice. Everything is clicking for her.
Yep.
Perfect. Just a little bit of a draw shot. Just go down bottom rail and towards the 8. Yeah, Bernie's got her hands full with Pearl. Look at that, she hit that nice. That's, you know, that's perfect shape too. I hate being exactly
dead straight. Yeah.
It just seems like when you're dead straight on, it makes it a lot harder to make the ball.
Well, oh. Pearl draws first blood, and she's only going to 3.
What's the matter there, Bill?
Oh, I was just looking at some farther rate. Yeah, Pearl's got a Fargo rate of 452. Bernie has a Fargo rate of 582. And after this event is over, Pearl's is going to go flying up. It's going a lot higher.
Yeah. Well, she's the star of her team, too. First round of the team match, her team was trailing 5-3, and she had 2 of the wins. But they made it her. The guys on the team stepped it up, and they're sitting and waiting for the finals. So not only is Bernie having a great tournament, Pearl's having one too. Yep. Bernie and her partner won the Scotch.
Did Adam Pearl Pine. Play in the Scotch?
Yeah, and I can't remember where she finished. Somebody is looking at the brackets. Can take a look. I'm pretty sure she played Scotch. I know Donner's probably got the CTS on demand open, and he can take a look at the Scotch. I want to say Pearl finished in the 5th-6th area, if she played. Nope, somebody said she didn't play in the Scotch.
Oh,
so.
Okay.
I know, I've seen her all week. It feels like she's played so many matches in the women's and the teams that I've seen her all week. All right, well, Bernie's got to get on the board here because she's already given up a 2-game spot and raised to 5. Hey, you know, with, she's got ball in hand. If she wants the stripes, I would shoot the 15, put the cue ball at an angle to draw it back between the 2 and the 9 to get that 9 out of there. because both of those balls are in bad spot. And see, now she's shooting that ball that's out in the open.
She might be going to roll up and then shoot the 10 and come down.
And come down between them? Yeah. No, Bernie's a smart player.
Yeah. And if she does that, she still has would have the 15 as a safety valve.
Yeah, so both of these ladies are having a great event. Oh, look at that. Did she bump it down enough to make it by the two?
I think so, but I'm not positive.
Yeah, she called that pocket, so yeah, it'll
go. Looks like it goes.
And just don't shoot too hard and get that 15 out next. Nice. Six ball was a good hold.
Yep.
She's got a nice angle here, too, I think, where she can just go the side rail and pop out to the middle of the table. Yeah, both ladies are having a great tournament. Bernie's finals of the women's singles and won the Scotch. And Pearl's in the finals of the women's singles and team event.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to say hats off to Kathy Kelly's team. It was all women's team. We didn't get enough women's teams for this event, so they opted to grab another player and jump into the men's teams.
Indeed.
And finished fourth?
Yeah.
Hooray. That's a good result for all women's team playing against mostly all men's teams. Come on.
No, she came a little bit short.
She should be okay, though. Just
put a little, cut the 11 in.
Yeah, put a little bit of a draw stroke on that.
Just come off the end rail and go towards the 12. Yeah, she wanted to come up probably another foot or so. Yeah,
I don't know. Is that 11 a little farther past the side than it looks?
Well, I don't know. Yeah. No. It's definitely makeable, but if she has
it's definitely
to cut
on the
it
lower end of the side pocket. Well, if she can cut it super thin, then she could two rail out. But you gotta make sure you don't hit it so fat that you scratch. This is one of those shots. If you can cut it thin enough, shoot it with inside English and come off that bottom rail straight towards your ball.
Yeah, sometimes we don't get the correct angle.
Right. Well, she's got a tough shot to get here, and then she's going to have a tough one to get shape on the 8.
Oh, she went to the corner.
Wow.
I didn't even think she could do that without scratching.
Yeah. Well, as long as she gets back to the table, that might benefit her more because she was going to have a real tough time getting shape on that 8 ball.
Yeah, but there's no guarantee she's going to get back to the table.
Not the way Pearl's
playing. Not the way she's been playing, yeah.
Seven, the six, roll down a little, shoot four on the side.
Yeah, she's in pretty good shape.
Then you're pretty much wide open. The only issue is the 4 and the 5, and I think she might go for the 3 first, then the 6. But some players don't like to go back up and down the table. And as long as that 6 ball's right there, you can get fairly decent shape on the 4 and the 5. Yeah, 4 and the 5 both go in that side, so either one.
Mm-hmm.
And then once one of those is out, then the other one has more pockets to go into.
I'm a little surprised she kept herself so long. She actually could have gone forward and gone off the end rail and come down towards the six and get a little closer. But
well, I can tell you the one thing I like about her game is she almost never draws a shot. She takes that natural roll and just works with it. And I'm with you. I'm surprised she didn't. She's okay here, though.
Well, she's fine, but that was a little interesting.
She could. I think she can just shoot this, draw back, shoot the five, roll forward, and then shoot the two. But she doesn't. She doesn't like to draw. If she has the angle to follow this without bumping the five, then go ahead and follow. But if you're going to bump the five, pull it back a little bit.
I don't think she has to go into the five.
Then she'll follow it on up then. Yeah, she's good.
She got a little more angle than she wanted. She
might decide
to shoot the two here first.
She'll shoot the two here. So what do you do here, Bill? You pull back between the eight and the five, or pull back
I'm thinking go up between the eight and the five. It's a little more natural, I think.
Right. I know guys like Shane and stuff, they just put a little power stroke draw on that and come around between the 8 and the 11.
Yeah, that works too.
And two rail up. And I think you want to be high on the 5, though, so that you can pull back over for the 8 in the same pocket. I don't think it goes by the 11. I think she'll come up right between the eight. Yep.
She hit it perfect. Well, does she have any angle to her?
Sure, she can go over and back across.
Does she have enough angle to do that?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, she hasn't hit anything wrong today.
Oh. She's going to hook herself.
Wow. Oh, I don't know why she went. I can't tell if she's got a shot on that, but I think she hooked herself.
Yeah, I don't think she can see it.
Wow, I'm surprised she went
forward
down the table.
Not sure where she was trying to get to.
That was a little surprising. Well, coming down the table, she really only left herself one easy shot, and that'd be in the top right corner. Yeah, I didn't like that. Well, I think all she can do is kick at this and then kick at it for a side pocket make. I mean, she's not going to end up with a safety.
Well, after that two-rail kick we saw her play in the semifinal, nothing would surprise me.
She ends up with a safety here. It's just pure luck. She's got to go for the make. Definitely gonna make this one an interesting one.
She hasn't called it yet. Now she called it. Kick it inside.
Not far.
Boy, she was pretty accurate.
Wow. She did not miss that by much.
Not at all.
If you figure on the contact point on that 8-ball, she was probably within a 16th of an inch.
Yep. Yeah, she left Bernie fairly straight here.
Yeah, you know, on this shot, I think she has some angle, so I like the power follow and two rails and out to the middle of the table. She might not have that.
Yeah, it's hard to say.
Wow. When your opponent hooks himself that bad and then leaves you this crappy of a leaf, it's just... Yeah, just...
Bernie was pretty smart there, not trying to force something.
Yeah, she's just going to accept what she's got and work with it. Wow. That's a long shot. Mm-hmm. And I think she's in the way. Yeah. I think it's not only long, but it's almost perfectly straight in. Mm-hmm.
She's just going to try to roll it in gently and shoot the eight ball, probably up in this corner. Well, she hit it pretty good.
Yeah, she did hit it good. Oh, and the barking dog is up again.
Good shot.
Good shot. That was a nice win and a very needed win for Bernie.
1-1. Bernie's going to 5. Pearl's going to 3. Semifinals and the mixed teams are underway.
I think the people that have been listening to our streams this week probably knew that based on the whooping. Like a little semi-truck, get a little air, any mini whoop. Got to release some. Well, 1-1 with Bernie breaking.
So I take it you guys could hear that woofing.
Yeah. Wow, rock salt load. I've been hit by that before. I was about 13 years old, and we decided we were going to go steal some corn. And this old crazy farmer came out of the... off the highway. It was dark. And some headlights hit us, and we started running. We hear this old man screaming at us, and heard some gunshots, and... he got me in the back of the shoulder.
Sting a little bit, did it?
Oh, my Lord, did it sting. And, you know, so I got home. It was like a mile to get back home. I got home, and my dad was freaking out. He's like, what the hell happened? You know, and I'm telling him the story. He's like, all right, well, let's go. That's got to be rock salt, you know. Because apparently he could see some of it on my back, and. He takes me in there and tells me to get in the shower, and I get in the shower, and he turns on the warm water, and, oh, I thought it stung before. And my dad started laughing. He's like, yeah, you got what you deserve, stealing. I'm like, I thought he was being all considerate, you know, trying to help clean it up, but no, he thought it was funny.
Did you get home with corn?
No, it was in a bag in the middle of that cornfield.
Well, Bernie broke dry, and Pearl chose stripes.
Well, I think you shoot the 14. Yeah, I don't know what she's going to do with that 10 ball and the 12 ball. She might be able to make that 12 on the side off the 7. That's not a real easy shot, but...
Yeah. I got a little short story for you. I don't know, I was probably 11 or 12, and me and my buddies, we used to go out and pick crab apples off people's trees, and we'd throw them at their windows. They wouldn't break the window, but they made a lot of noise. Some guy come bailing out of his house. We took off running.
You were a little heathen.
Yeah, and he hopped in his car and come chasing us, and I ducked into the woods and behind a tree. And I probably stayed there for an hour before I had the nerve to come out and get home.
Wow. Bill Stock, a heathen. I was just stealing food to eat, man. I really liked corn on the cob. I was going to eat it up. Steal something to chuck at somebody else. Man.
Nope, she didn't make it. She was trying to go back into her 12 and break it out.
She gave it a good effort.
She didn't leave a whole lot.
She didn't leave anything. What do you?
Can she see the 5? Can Bernie see the 5 over there?
You know, if I'm shooting this shot, I like the idea of I got to get my telestrator in. And shoot the 7 off the 4 up in that corner, and then everything's broke out. I drew a pretty straight line there, too.
You did.
Well, maybe she can see the 6, but you're still going to have some tied up ball. So are you guys seeing the telestrator on out there? I don't know, mate. You know, Jeremy could have pulled a fast one on me, only set it up so I can see it.
I think Bernie's going to play the 4-2 combo here and open everything up.
Yeah, it doesn't look like an easy combo. Yeah, maybe. That's why I was saying I like taking the 7 off the 4 because it spread everything out and then.
Yeah, they see it. It says it's purple.
Oh, good, because on my end it's pink and I don't like. But hey, I got one to play with, so I'm happy.
Well, Bernie played a safe, and about the only legitimate shot here is the 13 in the side. The 12 is tied up.
Well, you have the 13 there. What about? She kicks really well. Why not kick off the side rail here, and just kick that 11 over towards the 9, just to get it out of there. You're still going to give up a shot, but unless that, you know what, we need to look at it. See, you know what, that 10 ball goes by. So mm-hmm. I'm making the 13.
Yeah, and she's got 13.
Then shoot the 9, come up, shoot the 10 by the 1, and you may be able to take it off the 1 or follow it and get and break out with the cue ball. Uh-oh.
No, she's okay. She almost spun a little too far.
Yeah, but see, now it's not as comfortable of a shape shot for the 10. I don't know why she backed it up that far. I mean, you can get there, but me, I'd rather shoot a stop shot from a straight-in shot. But
the mouse
she can get there.
Story. Did you have a mouse story?
Yeah, I think I know which one he's talking about.
She's shooting 11. It must go by or else she's going to just block the hole.
It goes. Oh. Well.
Yeah, she blocked the hole. And it did.
Good thing it stayed there, really, yeah. Because, but if I'm Bernie, I'm just going to cut that one, put it, knock that ball in and put the one in front so the 10 don't go. Well, I don't know if Jeremy's talking about the mouse story that came to mind, but my uncle, and I won't say his name because he might be watching. I was a kid, and my brother was about 5 or 6, and we had caught a mouse in a mouse trap. My uncle poured some. Oh, the animal rights people are going to snap. But they poured some kerosene or something on the mouse and lit it on fire and let it go, and it ran about halfway down the driveway and stopped. And my little brother says, "What happened?" And my uncle turned and looked at him and said, "It must have ran out of gas."
Jeez. Yeah, that's not good.
No. But
poor mouse.
Hopefully that's the mouse story Jeremy was asking about. And no names were used. don't everybody out there act like you ain't never done nothing wrong. The cold mouse. Yeah, good Lord. Yeah, I'll tell that one in a minute. That's funny. Tell that story while I'm in Arizona where it's 250 degrees.
Well, Bernie has a shot. She's got the five up in the corner, the three up in the corner. Yeah. One's open.
If Bernie shoots these shots really well,
too. If she
too.
Can play that 4-2 combo on the side, well, she's ducking again.
Hmm. Well, she's either going to... She's trying to make Pearl either move that 12 or give up ball in hand. Yeah, so the cold mouse. So I was living in Alaska. It was January. Had a waterbed, so I'd tell you how long ago it was. And I woke up in about 7 in the morning, and I rolled over to grab a cigarette, and I saw a mouse sitting up looking at me. So I reached down real slow and grabbed my slipper. And I threw it at the mouse, and it bounced over the mouse, and the mouse didn't even move. Look at that. That was a pretty good try. I don't think she was going to be able to keep Bernie off it, that one ball, no matter what she did. But the mouse didn't move. So I rolled over, and I bumped Bonnie. I said, check this out. And she rolls over and looks, and this mouse is just sitting there on its hind two legs looking at it. And Bonnie's like, oh, my God. Now, keep in mind, I'm in a waterbed. We're good and warm. So Bonnie starts to get up, and she puts her feet on the floor, and she goes, holy crap, the floor is freezing. Well, what had happened was the heater went out in the middle of the night, and it was, I don't know, 40 below. And this mouse froze to death.
Oh, man.
Looking up at me, like, dude, wow. Please let me in the bed, you know? And luckily, we were in a nice, really warm waterbed, and you know, it was electric, so it stayed warm, but it got so cold, and we called the heater guy, and he's like, I can't be there for, like, a week.
A week?
Yeah,
oh my
I mean,
God.
They were just hammered with business, so the house didn't have a heater for a week, and it was a week that was 40 below. And by the time we got, you know, the heat fixed, the TV was frozen to the floor, and the carpet, and
jeez.
Yeah, it did tons of damage, and yeah, but yeah, the mouse was just sitting there looking at me.
Yeah.
When I threw the shoe at it and it didn't move, I'm like, wow, that's a bold mouse right there. But
I'm assuming
froze
the 4-2 combination is on. That's what
yeah,
she's playing.
Yeah, it's got to be. And she makes this. She should be open as long as that 4 doesn't go too far. Nice and easy. Yeah, Bernie has a
she's
nice
fine.
Stroke. Well, I shoot the 7 here. Pull over. Shoot the 5. 4. Pull back a little. Shoot the 8. I don't think you have to do anything fancy here at all. Yep, just like that. Might pull back just a little bit.
Yeah. Get fairly straight on that 4. Then she could draw straight back for the 8.
Okay, I don't know if anybody noticed that but me, but watch Bernie's backhand. She's got those fingertips moving around.
Mm-hmm. I saw that yesterday.
Yeah, and you know, I think she does that to make sure that she's keeping a nice loose grip on her stroke. Because as soon as you tighten that backhand, you lose all the action you want on the cue ball. I think she wanted to come back a little farther, but
get a little straighter on that floor. She might not be able to draw straight, you know, back to where she can hold her angle for the eight in the corner.
Well, if she could, yeah. She's going to pull it back. It's just, now it looks like she's going to go forward.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Well, can you come with just a little bit of draw? Just like a half a tip below center and just come down between the 8 and the 15 and then back up? Just a half tip below center and a little bit of right-hand spin?
I don't know. That's tricky.
So that you come down like this and then over that way?
Maybe.
I mean, that's a tight window, but...
Yeah.
Or she could shoot it with just a little bit of a punch so she hits this ball and pulls back. I got a telestrator.
She's going with a high ball. So the 9 or the 8 goes in this corner underneath the 9, too. And I think that's what she's going to play. Yep, she decided to try something crazy. And
end up with a bad result.
Take what she has, yeah. I think she's playing to go off the side of the 9, maybe?
Well, I can't tell.
Or just shoot it with... pocket speed where it'll just drop. It looks like she has a whole pocket almost.
Yeah, it looks like it to me too. Be careful, cue ball.
Yep.
Don't hit too fat and scratch.
She won't hit it that hard.
Oh, shit. Yeah, I think she was trying to go real 9. Well, here comes a safety issue.
Well, we might very well be in a spot here where they're going to call for a ref. Get Bernie kicking at that 8. We'll call Brett over. He hasn't done anything yet today.
Yeah, I think they're over there eating food, and I think that's just bogus. Well, and unfortunately, I think Bernie has got that 8 even... Even if she's down
she
here,
can't
she can't
kick it
make
in.
It.
Yeah.
Well, I don't think she can. It's hard to tell from this angle. But it almost looks like she'd have to double kiss it to make it.
Yeah.
Careful not to tie your own balls up. I saw a player the other day play a safety, and he made a huge mess out of his own. He just, like, rolled another ball up on top because he was just focusing on getting the cue ball where he wanted.
Yeah. Well, Bernie's going to kick underneath this 8 ball here. I think if she does it softly.
Well, she's got to be careful to not leave the 9 ball shot straight up in the corner.
Yeah.
Here comes Brett. Da,
da, da, da. He's got the camos. Da, 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 those camos.
Da, 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 da.
And sandals.
You get him a Superman outfit.
He's casual.
See, you know what I've learned by being on this side of the streaming? Is how to try to stay out of the camera when I have to go make a call.
Did she hit this hard enough to get it to the cushion?
Oh, she hit so close. So close. That would have been a great shot if the 8 would have hit the rail.
Yeah. Brett's hanging around in case it gets called again.
Well, at this point, I'm shooting the 9.
If the 9 goes, you shoot it.
Yeah, it goes up in the corner. In the way Pearl's been shooting, I'd go for the run out.
Yeah,
We'd like to welcome the viewers to Bad Boys TV. You're watching the finals of the women's division at the 2016 Southwest Regionals. We're in Scottsdale, Arizona at the Wecopal Hotel and Casino. Now, technically, the casino is called the Fort McDowell Casino. It's all the same area.
Pretty certain that if she's not going to shoot this nine, she's going to play safe again.
Well, the problem is, again, the more opportunities you let your opponent get back to the table when you have the possibility of getting out, you increase the odds of not winning.
Yep.
I'm really surprised with ball in hand she's not shooting the nine, but...
Yeah, she didn't call safe, I don't believe, so...
Yeah.
She did call safe. And here comes... Brett's going to be called up here again.
Well, and I'm not sure why she would have done that.
You know, pocket her ball, yeah.
Well, I mean, pocketing her ball's okay, but why not just stop the cue ball behind the 12?
That, hooker.
Instead of worrying about where you roll the cue ball up.
Or if she's going to roll her ball up, don't make it.
Get
it
right, because...
to where you can get a breakout.
Right, because now she can just come down and bump that 8 up.
Yeah, she actually would have been better rolling her ball up somewhere around the 9 and the 8 where she could use it to get a breakout.
I wonder what the little discussion there between Bernie and the ref was.
I don't know.
We'll have to interview him later.
Did she hit it hard enough to do it again?
Yeah, she hit. Oh, no rail.
Oh, no, he says it got it.
Is it?
Got the rail.
Wow.
Well, Brett was right on top of it, so he could tell.
Well, yeah, he's got definitely a better view than me. But
so now she just turned this thing around. Yeah. Now you got Pearl kicking at something.
She got Pearl in a jam, and there you go. You know, she had an opportunity with ball in hand.
She had a couple times she had opportunity to do something different.
Yeah, but she had ball in hand with a makeable nine, mm-hmm. and the other two balls were in the open, and she chose to play a save. Which, really, that save, I didn't understand why she brought the cue ball down the table like that. When she could have just shot the same shot and left the cue ball right behind the 12.
I'm not sure if she's kicking back at this 9 ball. Or can she see the edge of it?
No, she's kicking back at it. Alrighty. Yep, now, I think there's
Brett's
a window. Brett's going to go back to work.
I think he might call. Unless she can just see it real easily. Maybe she can.
Yeah. Well, there you go.
Okay.
When you have an opportunity.
Well, that was a big game for Bernie.
Don't want to beat the horse, but...
Yep. Sometimes when you just refuse to go for the win, it bites you.
Well, you know, and she had ball in hand on the 9, and the 9 was
makeable.
And it went. And I want to say from there, she probably had a 70% chance of running out.
Yeah, she just needed to follow up a little bit, and she had both two stripes
right
there by the corner.
But when she got into the safety battle, it's a 50-50 proposition.
Yeah, well, that one bit
especially her. When she rolled all the way down here,
yeah,
to give Bernie an easy kick at the 8. I mean, yeah, Bernie's not going to make it, but it looked to me like pretty much the worst case scenario she would have gave you. You know, if Bernie made the mistake of she was going to either give you ball in hand with the same 9 ball shot you had before and turn down, or she makes a good hit and leaves you a little bit tougher, same shot on the 9, yeah. But instead she hooked you.
Well, Pearl made a ball on the break.
Can't tell if that 9 goes by the 7.
I think it does.
But she looks like she's got...
she's got the 3 in the side, 5 in the corner, 9 in the corner. might have the four in the corner.
Yeah, five in the corner, three in the side, possibly the four. Let's see. Can't tell, but it looks like the four goes in the corner. The only tied up ball then would be with the solid, I think, would be the, if yeah. the four goes, then the one is the only tied up ball.
Well, she could shoot the four, get an angle on the six, and she could go into the, like, the 11 and get the one out of there, possibly. She's looking to see if that nine goes by.
Stripes. If she makes that nine and can get up table far enough, I think if the 11-10 go in the right corner, which it looks like it's lined up perfect for, mm-hmm. then really nothing's in the way. Yeah, I think she's wanting to shoot that nine ball. Nice shot. Got the cue ball up the table, so she has more options to shoot at. Well, the 13 goes in the bottom right corner, and that would break everything up right there. She could also shoot the 12 and break it up, too.
Yeah.
Just it matters on whether she wants to break them up or not.
Well, she's shooting a 14.
Well, she's going to have to pull back out of there, or just shoot soft and roll over for the 12 up in the corner. Yep.
Does the 15 go in the corner? Or the 12, I mean.
Yeah, I think it goes right by the 7.
If it's straight, she could just kind of stop there and play the combination.
Yeah. Oh, that was my neck. I need food. Does it not go up in the corner? Because that's what it looks like she played chip for.
She could still play the combination. It's a lot tougher being from that angle, but she'd have to hit that 13 really thin, or the 11 really thin.
Well, Pearl's only got to win two games. Bernie's got to win three more games.
Playing the combo?
That's what it looks like. It goes. She hit it just a little heavy. A little heavy. Didn't cut that 11 quite as thin as she needed to. But she's got that pocket blocked.
Yep.
Well, right here, I'm tempted to just shoot that 7 in the pocket and lead a cue ball right there.
Can she sneak that 1 on underneath the 10?
Well, if she can, then that's the shot to shoot. Yeah, if she's going to go rail first, I think there is room. Yeah. That was a nice shot.
Yeah, she's sitting pretty good, though, actually. Four goes.
Four, six, two rail out. Yeah.
She could play. Yeah, she's got an opportunity here to get out.
Yeah. Now two rail out of there. Well, some people like to just go.
She could draw
pop
out or go
up
forward or go through the center, yeah.
I like the two rail out of there, which is what it looks like she's.
Back towards you or go forward?
No, forward. Go forward. I just feel more comfortable. I can let that stroke go.
Yeah.
You know, put a little top forward. Cue ball should hit just between the second and third diamond up the left rail.
Well, and if you draw, it's a lot easier to rattle that ball
just
in the pocket.
Just like that,
too.
Right? See, yeah, she's second, good. She hit that just like I would. Or like I used to could.
Like you would attempt to do. Now she can just get off the rail and get pretty straight on that two in the side. She's golden.
Yeah, you don't want to mess with that five until last, because it's like automatic shape for the eight.
Yeah.
As long as you're on the right side of it.
Yeah, if she can get straight into that two ball, she's going to be really good. Kind of like that.
Yeah, that looks almost perfect.
She might have to pull it back maybe an inch or two.
Oh, yeah. A
couple inches. Yeah,
that is perfectly straight.
Just come back a couple inches. Well, did she? She's got enough to hold it. She can just roll it in gently.
Yeah, it's going
to
go. The cue ball's going to go towards the eight.
Of course, she could straighten her angle up by playing it off the 10. Then she could just roll straight up.
Right. I think that's what she's doing.
Don't overshoot it. Just nice and gentle.
Don't hit that 10 too fat. You'll be perfect. Just like that.
Boy, she
missed the 10. Yeah. That was a nice
shot. But she's still fine.
Really nice. Really nice shot there.
Well, Bernie lost the first game of this match, and Pearl had a couple opportunities in the second game to win, and she didn't. She played a couple safes when she could have really got out.
Nice
and
out.
All of a sudden.
Very nice out by Bernie.
Bernie has strung three games together and is now leading 3-1.
And it is now a race to two.
It's a race to two.
That was a very nice
Bernie's
out.
Bernie's break.
So if you're looking for a pool tournament later in the year, Texas Challenge. It's at the Mayborn Center in Temple, Texas. If you're a BCAPO or USAPO player, go to badboysbp.com. All the info's there. You can sign up online. It's going to be a lot of fun on that Monday, October 31st. We're going to have a costume contest.
One of these days, you ought to invite me down to work Texas. I've never been to one of those.
I can pay you $20.
$20 a day? Or
sure.
$20 for
yeah.
the whole tournament?
Yeah, we can. I might be able to squeeze $20 a day. Yeah, the October event's a new event. We're adding 3,000 to it. So, unfortunately, it's very close to another league event, but our players wanted another tournament, and that's the dates that were available, so that's what we're doing.
Well, Bernie broke these balls really well.
Both of these ladies break really good.
Yep.
Man, that last match, Veronica, was she really blasted.
Oh, she crushes the balls. So both of them are workable here. I kind of like Stripe. Well, got a 13 ball, that's a problem.
But it's not much of a problem if you can get the right shape.
You know, she could roll that 9 in right now and shoot the 13 up in the corner.
And just stop there and then shoot the 14. And then all the trouble is gone.
Yep, she's looking at it.
Yeah. Bernie's a smart player.
I think that might be the right shot.
She's a very smart player.
Okay.
Yeah, look at that. Really smart. This just stunned it a little bit. Roll forward. I think she'll end up pretty close to straight on the 14 up in the same pocket.
Yep. Pocket speed.
And if you don't think you can hold it up, go ahead and put a little good stroke on there and you'll roll up there and knock that 14 out of the bad position it's in. Oh, please hit it enough. Downhill, baby. There you go. What a shot.
That is what you would call perfect
pocket
speed.
Yeah.
And that's how she had to do it to hold that cue ball.
Well, I think,
like you said, she could have gone with a fuller stroke and gone right into the 14.
Right. Well, you don't want to move them if you don't have to.
Yeah.
But it's that particular shot is all about the comfort of, can you shoot
that
soft?
So good.
Yeah, she hit it perfect.
Now she's got a 14. She shoot 10 in the corner, 15 in the side, 12 in the corner.
There you go. She almost shot before I could get the camera switched.
Oops, she went a little far.
Yeah, but she's okay. She's got the 12 as a protector. I know she didn't want to roll quite that far.
No, if she would have got straight on the 10, she could have just rolled up and shot that 15 in the side.
Yeah. Yeah, she's not real happy with that position because she's so close to the rail. And I think... Well, no. I think she's okay to shoot that 10 and not have the side pocket as an issue.
Yeah, she wanted to be straight on that 10. What her plan is here.
Oh. Oh,
wow. Can
Lord.
She see the 15?
That's just brutal.
Can she see it? Well, she's looking at it. I think she
has to mass A on either one. Well, I don't think
she already called the 12 in the corner. She can't see the 15.
I'm not sure she can see the 12.
Oh, well, you know what? You might be right.
Look at this.
Wow.
I'm not sure she can see the 12.
Might be in that special spot where she can't see either one of them. Wow. Wowzer.
That is very, very unfortunate. That is brutal. Yeah, I don't think she can see either wall. Well, if she can't see the 12, then I would say the choice here would be to try to masse for the 15.
Closer to it, yeah.
Well, and you got more room to go around the corner of that side pocket.
She's hooked both ways.
Brett comes over and peeks one more time. I'm sending him for food.
He was looking at the score.
I know what he was looking for, but he gets close again and make him go get some food. Gotta say, I'm a little hungry. Wow. That is just not right.
Well, she's getting her jump cue out.
Yeah, I think she can jump the corner edge of that. If she shoots for the 15, she can jump the edge of that 10 on the side pocket.
Well, if she executes this and pockets that 15, the natural path of the cue ball is going to pop out and probably be straight in on that 12.
Yeah. Well, she's only 2 inches from that corner of the side of the pocket.
It's a tough
shot.
She's
got to get up quick.
Yep.
All right. This could be the shot of the match right here. Everybody up on their toes. Here it goes. I don't think she's got the cue up high enough. She got a good hit.
Oh, she's scratched.
Oh, my God. Wow. That's just mean. Yeah. Got over the edge and got a hit and then scratched anyway. At that point, you just got to ask the pool gods, why didn't you just scratch me to start with?
Yeah. Save me the extra pain.
Yeah. You got me in the jaws. You put me through the agony.
Yeah, see, that's what that angle on that 10 ball did to her.
Yeah, just a little out of position. And really, yeah, just she just nudged the 15 going by and it put her right in the jaw.
Well, Well, I'd take care of that 7 and the 3 and then just come down and play on this end of the table.
Yeah, I was going to say, I like the idea of shooting the 6 and getting it out of the way of the 5.
Well, she could do that, too.
Because you can put the cue ball here and then just shoot the 6, roll over here, get the 4 out, and then you got plenty of room to work on everything.
Definitely got options.
I don't want to take the chance of getting out of shape and not being able to get that 6 out of the way of the 5. Or you could just shoot the 5 first with ball in hand to the lower left corner.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's choosing to get the 2 in the other end first.
Yeah, you can do that too. It's a matter of preference.
The way they're set, and there's a lot of different ways you can go about it.
Yeah, she might go 3, 2, 4 and up, and I think I really would probably shoot the 2 here. I want to get rid of that 5-6 issue. I don't want to wait to the end because too many things can go wrong. I lose a little shape here, a little shape there.
Yeah, I don't have a problem with that. I'd do the 3 first and then the 2 maybe and go to 4. That's what she's going to do. Well, she's going to do the 3 first. Beyond that, we don't know yet. Mm-hmm. She stopped it, so it indicates to me that she's probably going to,
well, too many times.
She's going to go to the 6, but
yeah,
she's
too many times
something.
This week I've watched players save like that 5-6 situation for the last shot.
Oh, you
and then
can
they
get trouble.
Out, yeah, and they get out of line, and then they're jammed up. Yeah, see?
Well, she's got the one.
I got a little tougher shot. She had to put a little extra on the cue ball. And she's got a little tougher shot. I like to keep it as simple as I can. Yep. Looks like she's going to shoot the 1 in the side.
Yep.
You just roll forward or you put a stop shot on that? Just hold it right there.
I think I roll forward a little bit and shoot the 2 and then the 4, then the 5. Where they're sitting now. Still, there's still options on this layout. She could take the 4 next. Looks like that's what she's going to do.
Yep. Yep. Just hit this one just a little below center, and yeah, she's going to go 2 rails, it looks like. Maybe 1 rail. She's hitting it with a lot of right. There you go.
Just roll the 5 in, and she'll be fine on the 2.
Yeah, got to go 5 first.
If you shoot the 2, if you
don't get around the 12,
you
then,
hit the 12
then you get
then
the
screw yourself.
Bad angle. Oh, she's tormenting us. She's going to go the other way.
I would not go this way. The other way is kind of natural.
Right. Pocket speed, and you pretty much put the cue ball straight on the 2. But she'll do it the other way because that's what she's comfortable with. And see,
that's exactly what we were talking about.
Now you got either a really tough cut or you bank it.
Yep. See, if she would have went to the 5 first, you didn't have to put any English on the cue ball. Just roll it to the rail and out.
Right.
She would have been perfect on the 2.
Right. Well, and shooting the 2 first, she needed to hit it with draw and a little bit of right. And if she gets around the 12, she's got a big chance of hooking herself on the 5 with the 8.
Yep.
And you're running farther away from the ball.
Yep. Well, she called the bank, I believe.
Well, she banks pretty good. Yeah, she banks good, but look how far away she is at the
mm-hmm. Of course, she's been spearing these in all tournament.
Right. But she's doing it the hard way.
Yes. She missed it.
Yep. Yeah, and that all comes down to
Well, she got a little bit fortunate that she left Bernie straight in on that 15.
Yeah, she's been doing that a lot this event, too. Even when she misses, she leaves her opponent a really tough one.
I think Bernie's going to have to roll up a little bit and take that long shot on the 12. But Bernie's got to feel like she's fortunate to be at the table.
Yeah. A good shot to practice is when, like, the five was set up, is to practice shooting that and just making it and see how far the cue ball rolls across the table. Too many people forget to practice shape from certain shots that you see all the time. Well, I know Bernie would have loved to have gotten off the rail for this shot.
Yeah, but she just didn't. You know, she didn't want to take the chance trying to jam that ball in the pocket and rattle it. So she's smart. She's taking what the table was giving her. Give her the opportunity to win. Nice.
Don't go too far.
Uh-oh, she's...
Uh-oh.
She could play it either way now. But she's definitely... She didn't even hesitate. She called it. She's going to cut it.
Well... Bernie's wise. When the when you got a tough shot, just take the natural roll. It makes that tough shot much
easier. I'm looking
easier.
Around the monitor at the table, and it doesn't look like there's any danger of a scratch.
Shh, no jinx, no jinx, no jinx.
Nicely done.
And she held it up.
Well, Bernie's on the hill. 4-1.
That was a nice shot on that 8-ball.
Yep. Bernie needs 1 to win the championship, and Pearl needs 2 to extend it to a second set. Didn't try anything crazy on that straight in shot. She just rolled up and she took what the table gave her and she just rolled that last ball in and then made a nice shot on the 8-ball.
Well, Pearl's breaking. If she can get a break and run in here, then we'll be hill.
Well, she needs to. I wouldn't want to let Bernie get back at the table. Well, she made a ball, a couple of balls.
Yeah, she hit that. Look at that. See that pattern there? That's pretty funny. You got the three solids right there and the three stripes right there.
Yep. You're just playing with your telescope.
I know, but look at that.
Well, let's see where she's sitting. Which ones does she want?
Well, I'm telling you, I think I'm shooting the solids, and I'm going to shoot that 4. Then the 3.
And the 2 sitting perfect.
Leave the 2 right there.
Yeah.
Yeah. My only tough ball is really that 7 ball.
Two solids on the break, yep.
I'm shooting the 4. And if she can pop it over to the left a little bit. Yeah. Okay, now shoot the 1. You'll come around for the 7, shoot it, shoot the 3. If she can shoot the 1. And not hit the 7, and shoot the 1 and go here.
Mm-hmm.
Just like that. That's what I would do.
That's what she's doing, it looks like.
Alright, guy, I'm gonna go smack that guy in a second. Oh, look at that. Look how fortunate she got there.
Yep, she might have to take her 2 now.
Yeah, but I could live with that, because then the 8 goes in either corner, and she got the 7 over in front of the pocket. So, yeah. Just shoot the 2 with a little bit of right hand spin so you come up to the center of the table so you can shoot the 3, then the 7. Uh-oh.
She almost got in trouble there.
Well, she just took one of
the
pockets away.
She took one of
the
pockets away. And she's lucky she didn't hook herself in that stack.
Right. Well, now she got some work to get shape on that 3.
Mm-hmm.
I think you just... stroke this in nice and smooth and bring the cue ball straight over for the 3. I would not have done that. I would have come across here to this side. you're short, you can shoot it in the side there. If you're perfect, you can shoot it up here.
Well, Bernie has got it.
Bernie's got to be happy to be at the table now, because that really looked like it was going to be a run out.
Yeah. You know, first, my first thought was get those two from the other end, but I'm not sure that she should do that, because
I like
these balls are sitting a little funny down here. She might want to clean up some of this.
Yeah, I like shooting the 12 and drawing back into the 10 and trying to separate them that way. Or you can do it this way. Of course.
I think that was the match over there. That was a little louder bark.
I'm going to make them hold up. Yeah, it looks like the 10, as long as the 14 goes. If the 10 and 14 go in a lower right, then she ain't got to worry about anything. Mm-hmm. She can just roll forward and not have to break out anything would be... Yep, and I think that's the case. Now, if she's straight on the 10, she could shoot it in and draw straight back. Yep. Or just pop over and shoot the 14 the other way. Yep.
Now just roll this in, shoot the 12, shoot the 11, go down and get those two.
You want to get straighter on this 12. Oh, well, she can just kick it out of there. So do you get put a little pole on there and bump the 11 towards the left corner? Or just roll forward? And
I think I'd roll forward.
Yeah. Can't really tell the angle from here. We got to get our cameras up a little higher.
She's probably steeper than she wants to be.
Yeah, but both her balls are up at the other end of the table, so...
All she has to do is just make sure you pocket this ball. You don't want to hit it real, real hard.
Just roll up the table. Yeah. And I would much prefer to get the 15 next if it was me.
Yeah, because it's easier to play shape off that 13 for the 8.
Ooh, oh, Bernie. Oh, Bernie, come on. Don't touch it. Don't touch it. Oh.
We have seen that before.
That is just brutal. That is so just mean.
So what do you do? Come off the right side of the 15 and spin down underneath the 8? Or do you have...
Well, it depends on how good you feel about your position of the cue ball, because you could shoot off the left side of the 15, two rail back behind the 8 or the 13.
Yeah, but if you don't get there, you're going to leave her straight in the
side. If you don't get the right hit, you'll scratch.
Yeah. Boy, that little tickle. Amazing how much difference that makes.
Yeah, Jeremy, as soon as this match is done, I'm going to step out and have a smoke either way, so I'll be ready for a phone call. Well, yeah, I don't know. Kind of jammed up.
Well, I think you play safe and just leave her down here on this end rail. Make her come with a shot.
Yeah, but when your opponent can shoot like she can...
What?
I think she's...
Two rails?
Yeah, why not? She wants to show us since Pearl did it earlier. Did a two-rail kick. Bernie wants to show you a two-rail bank.
I don't know. I think...
She's
going to bank. Yeah, she's called bank it.
Well, this might not be bad.
True.
Because...
It's a much higher percentage.
If she gets the cue ball in the right spot, then Pearl would be left with a bank if Bernie doesn't make it. Yeah, one little tick here or there can turn a pool game into a lot tougher out than...
I think she made it. Oh,
man. Oh, but look. Oh, she got shape on that next shot. Well, Pearl's got to come with something here.
Yeah, and it doesn't look like she has the angle to go towards 8 ball. So she might have to shoot from that side rail over there if she makes this 3.
The races in this match are based off of their Fargo ratings. Bernie's got to go to 5, Pearl to 3. Bernie is on the hill. Pearl's at the table.
What did Dylan Hodges say?
I don't have a clue. I'll ask Rick later. Look at that. That girl can shoot. Mm-hmm. All right, we might have a hill match right here. Yeah, not going to tolerate any negative crap in the chat room. You wanna be negative, go somewhere else. Wow.
Hill.
Well, she came with it. And now the dance is on. Hill. Bernie's just gotta be brewing right now. She just hit that shot just a little too hard, rolled down a little too far. This is the women's finals. If Bernie wins this game, she's the champion. If Pearl wins this game, we're going to do it again. It's 2016 Southwest Regional in Scottsdale, Arizona. I'm Rick Jones. And next to me is Bill Stock. We are bad boys, true and through, nationwide. It's what we used to preach, but... Now it's worldwide. We've had Uruguay and...
There was some other country or two that was tuning in too. Oh, good break.
Belize.
Yeah, you just pray for a shot.
Holland was in here today. Belize.
Several of them.
Yeah. Yeah, I can't remember the other one. Sorry if I didn't mention you. Welcome, everybody.
Got quite a few people out there watching.
Yeah, Bonnie's walking this way. I'm going to tell her to make her hold the hounds.
Well, what if this double dips? Are you going to still hold it?
We're going to wait and see who wins. Yeah, if this double dips, then we probably won't hold them because that could be another hour and a half.
Yeah.
If Bernie wins, then
we'll bring the team finals.
Yeah, then we'll get the team finals over here. Bonnie. Right. If they double dip, then we can move them over. Oh.
If the ladies double dip.
Alright, well, we're trying to see what we want to do with the team, so. Yep. Belize and Holland, yep.
Bernie's looking pretty good here.
Hey, we got Alaska. What part of Alaska, Brett Evans? I used to live up there. I lived up in Alaska for a long time.
And I was born and raised there.
That explains a lot.
Well.
I loved Alaska. Well, don't get me wrong.
Now, Brody, shoot this 9 ball right now. Shoot the 10, 13, 11 in the side.
Roll down, shoot the 8 in the side by the 9.
I mean, they're all sitting there.
Let's just draw a big circle, Bernie. Shoot the 9. She's got to hold it so she can shoot the 10. She might go the other way.
I don't like going that way.
I think she's afraid she's going to get hooked shooting that 9 and not have a shot on that 10.
No, she just stopped her cue ball. She's got no angle on the 9.
Yeah, she's looking for a map. I think she's thinking 10, 13, 11 come around for the 9, but I don't like that either.
You got to move your cue ball too far. Yeah, she's coming back to the 9. She thought out all her options, and she came back to the best one.
Yeah, this is the right shot here. And she held it good.
Yep.
Now, when you shoot this one, Bill, do you just put a little bit of side spin, dead center, a little bit of right?
Just move it over closer to the 13 a little bit.
Yeah, throw it into the pocket, too, just like that.
Don't go too far.
Oh, Lordy.
Well, she's okay. She can either just stun her cue ball or go to the cushion and out.
Yeah, it's all a matter of choice here. That 7's blocking the 8 from that corner, so.
She can do it two ways here. She could 13 stop.
Yeah, she's looking
11,
at the side pocket.
Or she could even roll up and shoot it in the corner if we wanted to. But that's a little tricky because if you get the wrong angle.
She is looking at every possible pocket.
But she's sitting pretty good.
Well, and it's smart. You know, you're at a hill game. Take your time. Mm-hmm. Get it right. Do what you want to do.
I think she wanted to shoot it in the corner.
She has got such pocket speed. That's the second shot that just eked its way into the pocket.
Yep.
What a match.
Well, she's going to come down to the end rail, and she's going to go out heading towards the 5 ball.
I think I would, too. And for me, I would probably push it two rails, but it looks like she's just going to pop down and go 1 rail up.
I think she hit it really good.
Come on, run, baby, run.
It's okay. She's okay.
Well, here's the shot for the championship.
Well, all she has to do is concentrate on the shot. There's no danger
of scratching cross-eyed.
I'm not even going to say it.
There's no danger of scratching cross-eyed.
Yeah. Well, she could scratch in the corner if she fired it in, but she's not going to do that.
She's going to pocket speed this, because I'll guarantee you, if she misses it, it's going to be in front of that hole.
Yeah. She's not going to miss it.
That's where a lot of people make a mistake. They go for a blast, and they miss, and then every time they get back to the table, it's an unmakeable shot. Look at that. Boom.
We have a champion.
Way to go, Ernie Storr. Congratulations, Pearl Ortiz. Yep. Had one heck of a tournament, too. That was a great match.
Yep. Well, we'll take a short break, and we're going to come with the men's final here.
Congratulations, Bernie, for another championship. All right, Brett, we'll see y'all in a little bit, probably about 10-15 minutes.